Can you describe some feature of Callings?
Absolutely. So we have our Azure Communication Services Calling SDK. That's a lower level SDK that lets you embed a video calling, voice or video calling experience within your app or website. So if you picture a virtual visit between a healthcare provider and a patient, the patient is calling in to consult with their doctor or healthcare provider, and they're able to just do it either through a phone or a computer, website, whatever, and they're able to communicate with their doctor through the custom experience that the healthcare provider has. Maybe it's a website that they log into or just a mobile app. But the idea with our calling experiences is that there's two different calling SDKs that we offer. One is our calling client SDK, and that handles the client endpoints that are, like our patient in this case, that are just joining the call, and the doctor, for what it's worth, the healthcare provider joining the call. They're able to share their screen, share their video, mute, unmute. They're able to, select what device they want to use if they have multiple cameras or mics. The other SDK that is now in preview is the call automation SDK. And that's meant to be for if you have a backend service that's going to be joining calls, you can record calls through the call automation SDK, meant to be more on the server side. So you can collect monitoring logs, view participants joining and leaving. You can also do some automation like, I mentioned recording or handling the calls from the back end. Now, something that we have as well, because I mentioned we have these two SDKs, we also have a UI library that makes it a lot easier to get started with our client calling SDK. For most video calls, things look very similar. There's a mute, unmute button. There's a device selection button. There's, maybe a hold or share screen or stop video. All these controls are very common. I think you'll find them in pretty much any video call you join. The UI library wraps all those experiences up, so you can get started with the calling SDK in, I think it's two lines of code now. So, of course, you can go through and customize all of those experiences for your users and make it, if you want to add some branding or some special event or experience that happens when someone joins or leaves a call, you can do all that for yourself, but you can also get up and running so quickly with our UI library and our calling SDK.
That's very interesting. Can you manage to do a demo in like 4 minutes and a half?
Absolutely. So I'm going to share my screen here. And this is our web calling tutorial. So we go through, it shows step-by-step how to place and receive calls, how to get started, initialize the SDK. What's cool about this tutorial and what I really like about it is, while it goes through step-by-step what to do, it also will show the code underneath. For example, this is acting as a simple web service that's going to create the tokens that are used for to identify the user in the SDKs. And it goes through and it shows here's how you subscribe to different events. So if you want to know when another person has muted or unmuted themselves, and you can handle those events and add those custom experiences that if you'd like to. So this is a cool tutorial. It's on our public documentation, so go check it out, definitely. But to show the demo really quick, I'm going to go ahead, and I have two different browsers, so it's simulating two different users joining a call. I'm provisioning an Azure Communication Services identity. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to copy this identity. We'll have user B, which will be on the right, call user A, who's on the left. Then we go ahead, I'm just going to paste in that identity real quick, and I'm going to place the call. And bear with me because sometimes it gets a little tricky managing the devices in terms of, if they get locked up and someone else is using it. So here we have the call incoming. I'm going to answer it with video. And we should see. On both sides. Okay, so I answered with video. Now I'm going to go and share this video. And let's see, hopefully it doesn't get too locked up. I'm using the pro cam here. I'm gonna try and use a different camera.
That's very impressive, by the way. While she's doing that, that's very impressive. She's already on the call sharing a camera, and now she's two instances. So I know she has multiple camera, but that's pretty cool. If you can just manage to do that in a few clicks, that's pretty amazing.
Thank you. I think, it's funny when we do these, when we do these these videos and presentations, it's kind of funny. We have the setup gets a little silly because we have so many different cameras to manage, you know, the real talk, and then we have cameras to manage not getting locked up in the actual demo as well.
And of course, I made you zoom so you cannot see anything in those screens.
Oh no, it's all good. I know if you see these events, these are new features. So it's sharing some diagnostic events and it says, you know, oh, someone's muted or and they're trying to talk while they're muted. So if you wanted to add a little flag that said, you know, like, hey, try unmuting if you're trying to speak, we can't hear you. That's what these flags are popping up. These events that are popping up are showing you. So it does give you some granularity and able to add these experiences to make it easier for your users. I'm now going to hang up. Let me see. I'll give it one more try. Actually, you know what I might do from over here is I'll just share my screen just to show that off. So here I'm selecting which screen to share. And if we go over on the left, we can see that I'm sharing the screen and user A can see my user B's screen. See that the video is a little frozen, but it's all good. We have a video call back and forth. Another common scenario that people use this for is any sort of advisory situation. So if you have a financial advisor and you wanna go through your portfolio, you can share the screen, both be on a video call together, or even in educational scenarios, you could see where this is pretty valuable to be able to share share your screen, share your video, and connect with the other users on the call. And I will go ahead and stop sharing my screen now since we're just taking up videos and bandwidth and wrap up. But that's our calling SDK. So this was the calling client SDK. If you're interested in call recording, that will be the calling automation SDK, which is in preview. So go ahead and check out our documentation. It showcases all the features available. Even I touched on a few here, but thank you.